The first workshop was about project writing. It's important for them as youngsters and future volunteers to understand how they should manage a project.
I learned how to write a project, how to set it up, what steps should you do, and what those little things that are little but are very, very important. And it makes the difference between a good project and a bad project. So yes, it was the most helpful project, the most helpful workshop in this camp.
How we could make it even more possible that youth, so you people, young people, would have more influence in all kinds of decisions in your daily life.
Basically, they have to reflect on what is governance, what is empowerment, how the youth can be empowered at home, in school, using social media, who governs those things, what happens in their daily lives related to governance, youth and empowerment.
That was a very, very interesting one. It was fun to debate with the other colleagues about the subject.
This stop now. We have the proof. And when you have more and more people taking an attitude on a subject, then they can actually create change. You'll have left a huge changing potential that the next group, the next generation that comes up, will have to at least meet you. So if you can keep on raising your bar, what that means is the next group of people are going to raise it even higher. And that's what we want. We want evolution. So challenge yourself. We basically explored what other people are doing to help inspire creativity amongst the kids, as well as, you know, to see if they have any solutions they might want to apply to their projects.
He encouraged us to be on Facebook and Twitter and the internet, so it was great. I love it.
So basically I gave them the proper tools so that they can themselves become more advanced users. And the second part of my presentation was focused on privacy issues. I really wanted them to understand that the responsibility they have towards themselves, first and foremost, that whatever they post online, on whatever medium, is relayed to some server, to some database, in some place. So somebody always has access to your profile and can crunch that data into a profile that you necessarily wouldn't feel all that comfortable knowing that companies have that much information on you.
During the educational classes, I picked up some great ideas from the trainers. I really remember the trainer who spoke to us about Facebook and the great websites that are out there for gathering information, had some kind of advice that we should think about what we're doing. We should ask ourselves, why am I doing this? This was a great idea. I really love it. I really appreciate it. I will stick with it. I mean, it was, you know, it rang a bell for me.
Covered all cyber threats that the younger generation is seeing today, ranging from viruses and Trojans and malware to spam and vulnerabilities and basically all badness that is happening on the internet.
I also learned some new things I didn't even know about and I didn't even thought about how many viruses there are in on the internet that go around.
What have I done to you? Cut so deep, yet growing through and through.
Together a very nice scenario where we could imagine that an international jury were about to make a decision about forbidding internet in the at global level, and they were split it up into two teams and they had to argue pro and against forbidding of internet. And I was very glad to see with so much easiness they found so many good arguments, and it proved me that they are very well aware of the risks that they are facing when they use internet in an unhealthy way. And now the real challenge in their near future would be to implement this information in their day-to-day life.
Well, I was really surprised because I got a lot of yes and this and these answers, and I didn't really find myself as an addicted to the internet. But I think I'm going to do some changes, in fact, because I really see that that may be a problem. It's the right way forward, you see. It's not just a dream now. You think you know, you don't know. You think you know, you don't know. You think.
Children Romania and also in a strong partnership with INSAFE, we try to implement that the winner project in the next year.
The summer school was great. I loved it.
Very, very, very fun. I had a lot of fun. The people were very, very nice. The workshops were interesting. The presentations were interesting. And the free time was well spent.
Well, it's higher than my expectation. I never expected it would be so much fun.
Well, the summer school was my first, and it was the greatest camp I ever was in. I have never had so much fun. We did all the things I expected. I hope to be back again next year, and maybe in even 5 or more years.
Cultural exchange was very, very beautiful. I learned so much about others' languages, other countries.
Just to keep doing this and to invite us in the next years, maybe I love to come here again.
So I think that this was great, great experience, and I recommend you.
I hope when I go back to my country, I can pass what I have learned in this summer school to more people.
It was fun, I enjoyed it. Also, I won like 2 prizes. I was third in a dancing show with my colleague. And also, our team won the mask contest. So it was pretty funny.